fish.
That big log there, I can't get a good drift in there because of that. Just gotta kind of hope a real aggressive fish is hanging out there. I'll kind of take the nymphs in the middle column, not along the bottom. Just started fishing, so I don't want to snag and have to retie. See some branches right there. Some better water right up here. So approach a little more carefully than normal. The water's so clear. It's surprisingly deep, just with this little side channel. It's like almost over my head right in there. Oh, fish. It's a pretty good fish too. Figure out how to Ooh, that's a real nice fish. Gotta keep an eye on the logs. More pressure on him than I would normally like to, but if he gets on those logs, it's game over. That's pretty nice. Less than 5 minutes. Hooked into a real nice fish. Yep, just trying to get my log. Below me, so I almost got into it. Right. It's a nice fish. Might even be a steelhead. Just hammered the rubber legs there. Yeah, it's pushing 19 inches. Even to pushing 20 actually. Nice start to the day. Nice. The drift boat guys are, looks like they might be heading downstream. I have a group of four or five people just right above me. There's this drift boat. He must have got here really early. It's about 9 a.m. and they were already camped at that little riffle there. So I'm fishing my good old rubber legs. That's how that fish just tuck. I have a heavy 4.4 millimeter bead on there. I weighed it last night. I tied these last night and I weighed it. It was about 0.9 grams. It's pretty heavy. Man, that first cast right in there, you hammered it. And then below it, about 20, 22 inches below that, I just have a size 14 lightning bug. Looks shallow, like no more than a waist deep. Not that I would wade anything up to my waist with this type of current, but since it's below my waist, it should be fine. This is a weird place to fish. I don't think there's anything else quite like it. All these hills are mining, like slag, I'm not sure what you call it, but just mounds of dirt and rocks that they've piled up, mining all throughout this area. The river itself is a tailwater. It's very strange. You got these really shallow spots and these really ultra deep spots. I forgot to mention the insects that are prevalent around this time is the squala stonefly. This river is supposed to have one of the better squala hatches around. Although each time I fish this place, I think I've only seen one. Squala. You know, I fish a lot in February. That's supposed to be the peak month. This is March 1st right now. Still see some. There might be fish hanging out there. There might be some on the edge of the current. I don't know. It's hard to tell in this river. Very nice day out. It's supposed to be in the low 70s out here. Really feels like spring. Kind of arrived. I always viewed March 1st as the first day of spring. I don't really go by the solstice. good trip. Fish. Fish are known to be really good fighters. Can definitely confirm that. Really fight good for their size. This guy looks about, I don't know, anywhere between 14 and 15 inches, but he feels 18 or 20 inch fish. He's ready now. Nailed it too. Nailed it. See this poor fish. How much they get fished over. His right jaw is just mangled. Like from a big old screamer. Yeah, he looks about 15 inches. Pretty fat. Nice fish. Looking for some squalas. Just changing my battery. This guy showed up in my backpack. It's a real small one. I've seen it. Last time I was here, the only one I saw when I was here last time was a large one, but I think it was a female that had a big egg sac on it. They're pretty small, but I saw the flash on them.